And the least we can do is, when they're gone, if they, you know, when they're in Arlington, is to respect the rules and regulations that are in place, like not politicizing the fact that these men and women are there.
And we should note, because just because I'm old enough, I remember in 1999 when your dad, Senator John McCain, had campaign video that showed him walking through the cemetery.
Ain't nothing changed, nothing new here to see. This ain't nothing but some political maneuvering.
America!
Welcome to the eulogy, eat it up. It's called political buffoonery.
Hey there, everybody, and welcome to This Week in DUMBmocracy, where we showcase some of the dumbest newsmakers of the week. I've become a bit of an expert in political hypocrisy. After all, I wrote an Amazon best-selling, award-winning book called Schnooks, Crooks, Lies, and Scoundrels, a field guide to identifying political buffoons that's available right now on Amazon, at Barnes & Noble, and other online bookstores. The thing about hypocrisy is it's born out of the hubris that is also ingrained in politics. You have this idea, and it goes back to the founding of our nation, that one side has moral high ground over the other, and it switches from day to day, from topic to topic. It's always out there. So when the past week saw a manufactured controversy, in my opinion, concerning Donald Trump's visit to Arlington Cemetery, I knew I had to make a video about it and call out this hypocrisy. It's on many different levels, and we're going to go through all of them. But before we do that, please subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any other shows. And if you like what you see here in this or any other video on this channel, I'm going to ask you guys to please, without any hypocrisy whatsoever, smash that thumbs up button, like, comment, share the show with your friends, all that really good stuff, because all that's going to help the show grow via the YouTube algorithm.
Me, Missy Mao.
As always, gang, thank you so much for all that you do to help grow the channel. You know I appreciate all of your efforts, whether it's liking and sharing videos on the YouTubes, the Rumbles, the Twitters, wherever you find them, or if you're buying merch from shop.buffoonoftheweek.com. We have a whole assortment of items there that you can check out.
This guy is a grifter!
Thank you, however you're supporting the show. It's really, really helping. And for all you newbies out there who may be finding the show for the first time, I hope this video earns your subscription as we talk about Donald Trump's participation in a ceremony with a group of Gold Star families in Arlington National Cemetery that was in remembrance of the 13 American soldiers who were killed in Afghanistan during that disastrous withdrawal in 2021, presided over by the Biden-Harris administration. This is becoming a political hot potato on leftist social media and also in leftist media in general because of comments from the Democrat designee, Kamala Harris, talking about on social media how Trump was staging a political event and shaming military families. Let's get into it right now. As I was saying, Vice President and current Democrat designee for President Kamala Harris accused Donald Trump of staging a political event during this ceremony at Arlington National Cemetery, where Trump was invited by Gold Star families to participate. She said on X, "As Vice President, I have the privilege of visiting Arlington National Cemetery several times. It is a solemn place, a place where we come together to honor American heroes who have made the ultimate sacrifice in service of this nation. It is not a place for politics." Remember that as we go forward in this video. And yet, Donald Trump's team chose to film a video there, resulting in an altercation with cemetery staff. Let me be clear. The former president disrespected sacred ground, all for the sake of a political stunt. Now, that turned out not to be exactly true. As I said, President Trump was invited to attend this ceremony, and while he was there, photos were taken, video were taken, and they ended up on President Trump's TikTok.
We lost 13 great, great people. What a horrible day it was. We didn't lose one person in 18 months. And then they took over that disaster, the leaving of Afghanistan.
That video and the participation of Donald Trump in this ceremony with photos and video taken It drew the ire of the family of the late Senator John McCain. You know his story by now, being a prisoner during the Vietnam War, his service to the nation as a member of Congress, as a senator. He ran for president as well. And this is an interview with his son, Jimmy McCain. He himself is a veteran, and we certainly thank both Senator McCain and his son for their service. We appreciate veterans here, regardless of political opinions. But the younger McCain is not showing up here as a member of the family speaking on their behalf. He's here as a surrogate for the Harris-Walz campaign, having recently changed his party affiliation from independent to Democrat and endorsing the Harris-Walz ticket. Let's get to the video now.
Tell us why you called the visit to Arlington a violation.
Thank you for having me, sir. Well, as you well know, sir, Arlington Cemetery is sacred to all people who have, all people who are members of the military, all people who have served in the uniform. It's a sacred area. There's three generations of McCains that are buried there. It's a violation because these rules are set in place. The people who are buried there don't have an opinion. The point of Arlington Cemetery is to go and show respect for the men and women who have given their lives to this country. When you make it political, you take away the respect of the people who are there.
Now, I certainly agree with the statement and the sentiment, but let's remember Donald Trump was invited there by families, invited to participate in the ceremony. It was a solemn event to them, especially because neither Joe Biden nor Kamala Harris really commemorated this solemn anniversary of the death of these soldiers in Afghanistan. In fact, there's a lot of bitterness with these families concerning Kamala Harris's particular silence and not commemorating the passing of these soldiers. So while I can understand the younger McCain's opinion here, especially him being a soldier, a member of the military, I think he has his facts wrong about the purpose and the intent of Donald Trump's presence at this event.
So you're recently back from a 7-month deployment to Tower 22 in Jordan, that's near the border with Syria. Three U.S. soldiers were killed there just this past January. This idea of a sacred space and grieving families, it's not just theoretical for you.
Yes, sir. I mean, I was not personally at Tower 22 when that attack happened, but after being directly on the ground right after, I understand the pain that we saw there, the young men and women who are serving there and what they went through. Once again, it's a solemn thing. You know, these young people are taking time out of their lives when they could be bettering themselves, you know, college, things like that. And they're joining the military because they feel it's the right thing. And the least we can do is when they're gone, if they, you know, when they're in Arlington, is to respect the rules and regulations that are in place, like not politicizing the fact that these men and women are there. Go, show respect. I understand that he was invited. Show respect and leave. It doesn't need to be videoed.
Okay, so I guess he did know that Trump was invited to this ceremony. And has umbrage, I guess. He's taking issue with the videoing that was done there. Now, if it was done with the permission of the families, I understand that it may violate the cemetery rules. But if the families are there not taking offense, then what exactly is the issue we're raising here? This is why I call it a manufactured controversy. But what you're about to hear going forward in this interview should raise even more of an eyebrow. Listen to this.
Now, there is a difference between video from Arlington showing up in campaign ads and going to actually expressly film at Arlington for the purpose of a campaign ad. And we should note, because I'm old enough, I remember in 1999 when your dad, Senator John McCain, had campaign video that showed him walking through the cemetery.
Excuse me? A baking powder?
Yes, I'm old enough to remember this too, and I'm here to show you part of that campaign ad right now.
John McCain, dragged off by an angry mob, when found to be the son and grandson of admirals, was offered early release. He refused. McCain's commitment to country and fellow prisoners bought him repeated beatings and 5.5 years in prison. He returned home, spirit unbroken, again devoting himself to his country, Navy officer, congressman, senator, taking on the establishment and defying special interests, and never forgetting those heroes with whom he served.
Oh, what do we have here? John McCain, when he ran for president in 2000, he specifically filmed himself walking through Arlington National Cemetery. This seems like an egregious violation of Arlington National Cemetery's rules. So if we're mad at Donald Trump for incidentally filming while he's at a ceremony, not going there with the express intent to film a campaign ad, I would think that Jimmy McCain, the senator's son, would be able to lend a little grace to Donald Trump after his father was not only caught with this footage in a nationally broadcast campaign ad, but for also having to take out this portion of the footage from this nationally broadcast campaign ad. Let's head back to that CNN interview to see if Jake Tapper puts that question to Jimmy McCain.
After it was pointed out that some people thought that it was inappropriate, your dad called it a very bad mistake and apologized for it. If Donald Trump apologized for it and called it a mistake, would he earn any points back with you? I recognize it's not the exact same thing, but I'm just wondering, because this really seems to have bothered you that Mr. Trump did this.
It's a great question. And there's really two ways for this to go, right? Either Jimmy McCain can say, if Donald Trump capitulated, called it a mistake, took down the video, I would give him the same grace that my father received when he did the same thing back in 1999. Or Jimmy McCain is going to take the low road, think about the vendetta between his family and Trump, think about his role as a surrogate for Kamala Harris, and give the political answer of trying to dance around the hypocrisy of it all. And, well, let's see what road he takes here.
Yeah, I mean, the first thing about, John McCain, you don't spend that long in politics without messing up once or twice. So, and the main point is that he pulled it down and he understood the solemn, sanctified nature of Arlington National Cemetery.
Sounds like he's going the route of forgiveness here, I think. Well, at least I can hope he is, right? But let's see if he does.
So if Donald Trump pulled it down and apologized, I mean, it would be the right thing to do. But look at his history towards veterans. Look, at this point, I don't know what else he has to do, The answer is no.
Hypocrite!
The answer is no, because Jimmy McCain is acting like a political hypocrite here. He's on a political mission. He's not on a mission on behalf of his family or on behalf of veterans in general. He's there advocating for Kamala Harris and Tim Walz. He also said in this interview that he is changing parties to Democrat and endorsing them. Not to mention the fact that the McCain family has this lingering animus, and I'm not saying whether it's rightly so or not, but they certainly have this animus towards Donald Trump based upon past comments he made about his father. So in that sense, it's furthering that vendetta, and he's going out of his way to hurt Donald Trump as well.
Sometimes you get a twofer.
So while I can understand vendetta, I can understand a son sticking up for a father, I have to call out the hypocrisy of Jimmy McCain. And when we come back from the break, the hypocrisy goes even further into the Harris-Walz campaign, when you see what happened back in 2020 when then-President Joe Biden was putting out a Memorial Day campaign ad. Like what you see so far? Go ahead and smash that thumbs up button. Also, leave us a comment and tell us what you're thinking. And don't forget to subscribe so you never miss another show. So this is an ad from the Biden campaign in 2020 before it became the Biden-Harris campaign, to commemorate Memorial Day. And as we open on this ad, look what we see here. A photo from Arlington National Cemetery of a soldier, I guess, praying before a grave. Now, what about the sanctity of Arlington National Cemetery? I guess that wasn't in Joe Biden's mind, despite the fact that he had served as a senator, he served as a vice president. He wasn't thinking about that, or his campaign wasn't, when they put out this ad. Now, it's going to go into COVID and all this stuff because that's what was in the news in 2020. But look at the imagery of all this military personnel living and dead in this ad.
Here, Memorial Day feels a little different. This pandemic is showing us that service and bravery and willingness to stand on the front lines to help and protect our fellow human beings is not just the quality we find in our service members.
Now let's skip ahead to the end of the video.
That's much too early. Prepare to fast forward.
Preparing to fast forward.
Fast forward.
Fast forwarding, sir.
I'm going to spare you watching the entire ad, but skipping to the relevant part at the end here.
Thank you. We owe you. We can never lessen the magnitude of your loss.
That's a soldier planting flags on the graves in Arlington.
This I can promise you, we will never forget.
This is a photo from when Joe Biden was vice president at a grave in Arlington during one of these memorial ceremonies that happened there frequently, where politicians are invited to participate. This is from, I believe, 2010. And Joe Biden is right there in Arlington with military personnel. You clearly see a headstone of a soldier. And this is being put into a campaign ad. And if you don't believe that it's a campaign ad, let's go to the end of it here, because we're going to fade to black in a moment. And we're going to see a Biden for president bumper is what they call it. This is at the end of the ad with a text link to get to Joe Biden. And this is clearly using Arlington National Cemetery as a backdrop for a published campaign ad, much the way John McCain did it.
I mean, isn't that just the height of hypocrisy?
Now, we can certainly split hairs between the Biden video, the McCain video, and the Trump video. The Biden video has a still image from when Biden was vice president, but it still has that backdrop of Arlington National Cemetery in a political ad. Then you have John McCain intentionally filming part of the campaign ad within Arlington National Cemetery. And then you have Trump posting a video to his campaign TikTok, I think it was, that wasn't necessarily filmed for the purpose of winning votes, but to commemorate the ceremony. You heard it during the video. It certainly had more of a dual purpose.
Sometimes you get a twofer.
I'm not going to be so naive to say it wasn't a campaign video, but it certainly had the dual purpose of commemorating that those moments with those Gold Star families and recognizing those soldiers and how they died needlessly. But I think we see the subtle differences between them. And if we rank them in order of what was most egregious to least egregious, at least in my opinion, I would put the McCain video at the top. I would put the Biden video second and the Trump video third. Do they all have a commonality of using the graves of dead soldiers as a backdrop for a campaign? Absolutely. But it is certainly hypocritical now for John McCain's son, for the Harris campaign that was born from the Biden campaign, to now cry foul and manufacture a controversy against Donald Trump, their political adversary, or their personal vendetta, whatever it was that drove it. It seems to me that they're all wrong or they're all right. You can't just pick and choose winners and losers in this situation. So when we talk about hypocrisy, it's coming from the Harris-Walz campaign in the form of Kamala Harris's tweet and Jimmy McCain's interview on CNN. Now, lost in all this hypocrisy is the real egregious behavior that we haven't even gotten to yet. And that is the failure of Kamala Harris to even acknowledge or commemorate or memorialize the passing of these 13 American heroes in Afghanistan. And in response to this manufactured controversy, many of those family members created videos to send a message to Kamala Harris.
Our kids were murdered because of your administration.
You were not at Dover for the dignified transfer. And no time have you reached out to me to offer your condolences, to offer thank you for Kareem's sacrifice and service.
You have 13 families who have been waiting over 3 years to so much as get a phone call, to so much as hear our kids' names said aloud.
You failed for 3 years and 8 months.
to acknowledge our kids.
Where were you and Joe Biden on August 26, 2024? Nowhere near Arlington Cemetery. You couldn't be bothered to be with us or even say our kids' names, just as you had done for the last 3 years.
Vice President Harris, I ask you, why won't you return a call and explain to us how you call my daughter-in-law's death a success? President Trump has called. President Trump shows up. But President Trump takes the time to hear our loved one's stories.
We invited him to be there.
These are the only memories we get to make with our son, and it is you who is playing politics and trying to detract from our memories made that day.
President Trump has been there for us. He's been a rock for us. He showed compassion for us, and he showed he truly cares for the families that truly do know what the ultimate sacrifice really is.
While we're all quibbling over who's more wrong than the other and pointing fingers when fingers should be pointed back at each other and all this political buffoonery, we're losing the lead story here. We're burying the lead. And the lead is Kamala Harris had no time, apparently, to even bother to acknowledge the deaths of these heroes. Donald Trump did acknowledge the deaths of these heroes. And that draws a clear disparity between what's in the heart of these two politicians. Kamala Harris didn't. Donald Trump did. Yet Kamala Harris's surrogate is using his father's history, his family's military history, indeed his own military history, to attack Donald Trump for things his father did and things that this administration did that he's now endorsing. Yet Donald Trump is the bad guy in his eyes, mainly because the Harris campaign is exploiting the McCain family vendetta against Trump. It's a giant mess of hypocrisy, ladies and gentlemen, and everyone in between. And my advice to you is to never trust anything from any campaign, whether it be a campaign you like or a campaign you dislike, because it's all going to be spin control. And sometimes when you go beneath the surface and you look at what's going on, you'll see the true heart of the issue and who truly are the bad actors and who truly are the good actors. But at least that's just my opinion on the situation. I don't know what you guys think about this giant mess, what I'm calling a manufactured controversy. Let's get into the comments together. And as always, like and share the show with your friends, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of the shows. Let's talk about this kerfuffle of hypocrisy, as well as any other shenanigans and buffoonery happening every day this week in Dumbmocracy.
All views and opinions expressed here are not necessarily of the mainstream media. It may offend some listeners.
It's called political buffoonery.